Thank you. Coming to our CSCDH Banda concert. We're really excited to be doing this. At this time, I would ask you to please turn off your cellular devices or at least turn them the sound off, turn them to vibrate. Bienvenidos a todos a nuestro concierto de CSCDH del grupo de banda. Estamos muy se me fue el español. Muy contentos, agradecidos para hacer este concierto con todos ustedes. En este momento les pido por favor que apaguen sus teléfonos o a lo menos lo pongan en silencio. Ya vamos a empezar. Por favor, have a great time.
Okay. everyone. Thank you so much for attending this today's concert. My name is Ernesto Cruz. I am the director of the ensemble for today. Bienvenidos a todos. Qué emoción de estar aquí enfrente de todos ustedes. Una buena oportunidad para la comunidad oaxaqueña en tener música oaxaqueña en una universidad. Lo que voy a hacer es a introducir a mi compañero Hugo Tomás. Hugo, please come out. I'm going to go ahead and introduce Hugo Tomás. Come on out, please. I'm going to go ahead and have Hugo introduce what he just did. And I think this will give you guys a sense of meaning, belonging, as to what the Oaxacan community have in terms of music, cultural, and tonal expression. Voy a introducir a Hugo Tomás, nuestro trompetista. Les vamos a explicar qué fue lo que él tocó, qué el significado para nuestra cultura oaxaqueña. I'm here, Hugo, go for it.
Well, first of all, I'd like to give a huge thank to el maestro Ernesto for inviting me over here today. Me gustaría dar un agradecimiento al maestro Ernesto por invitarme hoy y tocar algo que siempre, desde yo pequeño, siempre he escuchado cuando mi papá ponía grabaciones del pueblo. I would always hear these trumpet calls on VHS when I was a little kid from the pueblo, from the village where my parents are from. This specific call is from a village called Villa Hidalgo Yalala, which is in the Sierra Juarez of Oaxaca. Este llamado de la trompeta específicamente viene de Villa Hidalgo Yalala in Oaxaca. It literally can be dated back to the late 1600s, early 1700s, and it was not played on this instrument, which we know today as a modern B-flat trumpet. It was actually played on a baroque trumpet. Normalmente, esta llamada no se tocaba en ese tipo de trompeta. Yo nomás lo toco en esta trompeta por la razón de que no tengo un clarín en mis manos. Pero la música se atrasa hasta los años 1600, 1700, por esos años. Todavía sigo investigando más en la música baroca de Oaxaca. I'm still doing more investigations towards the music of Oaxaca, specifically Baroque music in Oaxaca, which, I mean, it's very, very big. The music overall dates back, like I said, to the late 1600s to early 1700s. This call basically is an intro to a festival or a party for the village when they do their patron saints parties. Esta llamada nomás es como una llamada para la introducción, una llamada para que ya va empezando las festividades del pueblo, básicamente. Y bueno, eso es todo. That's pretty much all.
Thank you. Again, thank you guys so much for coming. We're going to go ahead and get started with our program. Enjoy, relax, open up your ears. Think of family members when you're hearing these beautiful music that our ancestors from Oaxaca left us. I do want to give a big thanks to our music ed option head, Dr. Kathleen Jenner, for actually inviting me and researching what opportunities Dominguez Hills has to promote diversity and inclusion and to promote equity amongst CSU campuses. I will say I am proud of Dominguez Hills, as this is one of the first CSU to ever host a band or ensemble that reflects a community of who they serve in this institution. So congratulations, CSU Dominguez Hills, for doing this. This is a tremendous work that you guys are doing, and I hope other CSUs follow your lead.
Un agradecimiento para la Universidad de Cal State Dominguez Hills por traer este ensamble a la universidad. Es la primera universidad que está ofreciendo este tipo de ensamble para parte de un currículo que tienen que hacer para su carrera. Y estoy muy, algo que no pensé que esto iba a pasar en estos tiempos. Especialmente agradecer a Dr. Kathleen Jenner. I'm not sure if she's in today. She might be Zoom then. Pero les agradezco a ellos y la Universidad de CSU Dominguez Hills. So, relájense. Vamos a tener un small intermission. Y luego, yeah, let's go for it. Okay, thank you. Let's go ahead and join. Thank you.
An enormous array of music. And this piece in particular, Tri, which is a bolero. And around the 1970s, our parents, my parents, right, and other parents, were in love with boleros, right? We're in love with these type of emotional pieces and type of music. And Tri, for me, happens to be one of these pieces that kind of emulates what I grew up with in terms of music, Oaxaqueña, and in terms of expression of love and emotion. Tri is a very common bolero in the Oaxacan community. And for the ones, for those who are from Oaxaca or in our Sierra, we'll get familiarized with this this bolero. El bolero Creí, que va a ser la siguiente pieza, es una pieza que ambos en la comunidad oaxaqueña, específicamente obvio en la Sierra Juárez, conocemos mucho. Tiene mucho sentimiento, mucha expresión en aquellos tiempos, ¿verdad? Como que yo no sé, en aquellos tiempos, la música bolero de boleros les gustaba mucho a nuestros padres y a nuestros ancestros. Y esta pieza para mí significa mucho. I'm from the community of Santa María Xochixtepec, one of the first bands out in the States. I will say that it was established around the 1970s. And for us to acknowledge them, and so they could, so we could give that this town, my town, that respect, that that thank you for bringing the music of Oaxaca to the States. At that time in the 70s, it was very difficult for acceptance of music of Oaxaca to be out here. And it was very trying times for them. And the band, my band, or my former band, Santa María Xochixtepec, is still going right now. It's past 40 plus years already. They're about to hit their 50 years. And to have that band here and still play music is tremendous. And I think they deserve a great shout out to for them keeping the traditions that the Oaxacan community has. So if you guys could do me a big favor, give them a big round of applause. I really appreciate them. You know, it's something very difficult, and you know, I was fortunate enough to be one of their conductors in my E days. And you know, as life happens, we need to move forward and need to open up new opportunities like Dominguez Hill did for me. Un agradecimiento a la comunidad de mi pertenencia, Santa María Xochixtepec, por tratar o por traer la música oaxaqueña en los Estados Unidos en los tiempos de 60, 70. Ellos fueron las primeras bandas que comenzaron una banda filarmónica aquí en los Estados Unidos, específicamente en Los Ángeles. Y un gran agradecimiento a mi comunidad, a mis paisanos,
por continuar expresando la música y las tradiciones que nuestros ancestros nos dejaron. So, mil gracias a la comunidad, mi comunidad de Santa María Xochitepec. Este bolero es algo que yo sé que ellos conocen mucho y ojalá que les guste. Thank you and hope you guys like this piece.
Thank you.
last piece, do want to let you know, after this piece, we'll go ahead and have a quick intermission, 7 minutes, and then we'll go ahead and start on our second. Okay.
Antes de comenzar esta pieza, vamos a después que terminamos la pieza, vamos a tener un intermission, un descanso de 7 minutos, y luego vamos a regresar para atrás para escuchar la segunda parte.
Oh, esta canción, canción mixteca, se toca mucho en tiempo de Galaguetza. This piece, Canción Mixteca, is known during our festivities of La Galaguetza. It's well known, it has a lot of color, and I think it explores more on melody and shifting the melody. So in this case, you're gonna hear a solo, a baritone and tenor sax, which is at this time, we're moving forward with music and it's changing of a stylistic approach in the Oaxaca community. So enjoy this.
Thank you.
So we'll go ahead and have a quick intermission. Be back at 7 and in 7 minutes, and then we'll go ahead and get started with the second half.
Thank you.
All right, so let's go ahead and get started on our second half. I'm very happy, and I'll introduce him later on, that we actually have one of our composers here today. But more to come on that, so let's go ahead and just get started.
Thank you.
this next piece, backstory. In Oaxaca, of course, we are known for our sones y jarabes, our traditional songs. But you'll notice that in the city, we play danzones a lot. And I was fortunate enough to meet the composer from Villalado, Yalala, he wrote this wonderful danzón called Ofelia. It's very unique in the sense where it's a non what we call traditional way of starting a piece, especially for a danzón. You know, we usually start out very strong, very full of energy, but this one doesn't. It has its uniqueness, and it's a great opportunity to hear the different nuances that the ensemble can create with the music. Esta próxima pieza es del compositor de Yalala, Villalado Yalala, Jaime Allende Cuevas. Tuve la oportunidad de conocerlo. Y este danzón es algo que tradicionalmente no está conocido como un danzón. Cuando uno escucha un danzón, uno piensa que va a comenzar fuerte y con un ritmo, pero este danzón va en otro modo, comienza el piano y regularmente no es típico para un danzón. ¿Qué escucharon? Let's go ahead and hear this danzón.
Thank you.
this next piece, I'm very happy to be introducing this piece. In the Oaxacan community, we are very big in giving everyone an opportunity to explore, to shine, to be able to be a musician at will, right? And we're hoping for always opportunities. These past pieces that we were playing were actually from composers out in Oaxaca. And this next piece, Blanca, which is a song, actually is from a composer that is from LA. And this is a very big thing for us because we are expanding. We are having the community be able to showcase what we have here, to showcase our product of Oaxaca and all the great music that we're able to provide. And having this piece being played here, and specifically from a composer that's from LA, Los Angeles, to be able to give that opportunity. Esta siguiente pieza es de un compositor que actualmente está en Los Ángeles. And correct me if I'm wrong, you're born here. Y nacido de aquí. Y qué gran oportunidad de enseñar todo lo, la potencia que Oaxaca tiene en los Estados Unidos. Hay que escuchar. Ya, let's hear it.
Thank you. gusto de estar aquí y de escuchar una pieza de mi autoría. Y bueno, lleno de emoción. Y,
a man of few words. Thank you so much. Chris. So it's very unique, you know. Music, you know, it's been ample ages, right? And he's just 17 and composing this wonderful music. And I am very excited for him and seeing where else he could go with music. So congratulations. To you, congratulations a la mamá. Le felicito por tener un muchacho que está empeño con la música. Very happy, and I'm looking forward to hearing more of your work. Thank you. This last piece. Is very known in the Oaxacan community. One will say it's our national anthem. It's funny, I always say it, and people laugh where I say Oaxaca is its own entity, and then there's Mexico. And this piece is very gonna be much, holds down the root of Oaxaca, it has its expression, and it's known for it being its national anthem for the Oaxaca community. With that, we close with Dios Nunca Muere, our national anthem for the Oaxaca community. If you're able to, please stand, as this will be a great closing, and of course, in our tradition, if you have a hat, please take it out of due respect for our elders and the ones who passed to the better life. So without further ado, Dios nunca muere.
Thank you.
have one more that the group wanted to play. It was one of the first pieces I brought to them. And as a matter of fact, this piece in my town of Santa Maria Suchixepec, we tend to play it a lot in 15s. It's a vals, it's called Flor de Canela. And it's very, in our community, for some odd reason, we love this bus. And it brings very meaningful thoughts for us. They've played it since the 70s, and to this day, they still play it. La banda quiere tocar esta pieza. Esta pieza es un vals, Flor de Canela. Actualmente, en mi comunidad de Santa María Xochitepec, es bien conocido este vals. En cada quinceañera que vamos, siempre tocamos esta pieza. Let's go ahead and hear it. Showcase the wonderful music of Oaxaca.
I really thank the music department for being able to produce this, to be able to be willing to offer a course like this. Again, it's a very unique situation where the first CSU actually offers this course. Estoy muy agradecido a la Universidad de Cal State Dominguez Hills por ofrecer este tipo de curso para nuestros estudiantes, para que enseñemos la cultura oaxaqueña y más. Ojalá que en los siguientes semestres continuamos con la música oaxaqueña. Les tengo otra sorpresa. Obvio, en nuestra comunidad siempre tenemos nuestros sones y jarabes. In our community, I'll have another surprise for y'all. We typically play our sones y jarabes, which is usually of dances and festivities. So this is actually going to be played by a couple of us. The group can stay here. Hugo, can you come out? Chris, can you come join us? And your brother, please, if you guys could join us. And you guys are going to hear actual authentic jarabes, sones y jarabes, all memorized and all play with traditional sounds. So give us 1 second. Enjoy and reminisce all the music of Oaxaca. Thank you all.